Good morning, Bears. Welcome to this week's edition of the WBBN News. I'm Jacob.
And I'm Liam. We have a lot going on today, so please listen up to the following announcements.
Brevard Public Schools will be hosting a college fair that highlights historically black colleges and universities in observance of Black History Month. This event is a great opportunity to meet HBCU college reps and alumni. In addition, application, scholarship, and admissions information will be discussed. The event will take place Tuesday, February 15th from 5:30 to 8 p.m. at the school board in Vieira. To register for the event, visit brevardschools.org.
Do you like to write stories? Do you like horror, sci-fi, adventure, young adult, romance, or other genres? Check out the new Creative Writing Club after school, Thursdays in Ms. Gaffey's room, 692. Or ask your English teacher for a flyer.
HOSA will be selling Valentine's Day Teddygrams starting February 4th through the 11th during A and B lunch. Cost of a ticket is $5. Teddygrams will be delivered on Monday, February 14th during first period. Come out and support HOSA while putting a smile on someone's face.
Students, it's not too late to purchase a yearbook. They're on sale now at yearbookforever.com for $80. Or you can stop by room 642 before or after school to purchase one. They will only be sold until March 30th, so reserve your copy today.
We'll be right back after this.
Good afternoon, Bayside. My name is JC, and in honor of Black History Month, I want to share my story today about Emmett Till. Black History Month is known for celebrating great Black Americans and their history and achievements, but our history is also filled with a tumultuous past. The purpose of this month is also to reflect upon those who suffered and sometimes gave their life during a time in which our country was very divided. Emmett Till was a young African American from Chicago, born in 1941 at the age of 14. Till was visiting relatives in Money, Mississippi in 1955 when the 14-year-old was accused of whistling at Carolyn Bryant, a white woman who was a cashier at the grocery store. On the evening of August 25, 1955, Till and a few friends had just finished up playing a game of baseball at the park and were thirsty. They stopped at their local convenience store to get a cold drink. Nobody truly knows what happened in the store. According to witnesses, the wife of the store owner accused Emmett of whistling or flirting with her. Later that evening, as Emmett and his family were going to sleep, the husband and the brother-in-law of the lady who accused him of whistling at her kidnapped Emmett. Emmett was beaten and shot in the head. The men disposed of the body in a nearby lake. Emmett's body was found that weekend. Emmett's mother was devastated by the news. Despite her grief, she made the bold and brave decision to have an open casket at his funeral. His mother was quoted saying, "I think everybody needed to know what happened to Emmett Till." 50,000 people in Chicago came to attend the funeral and show their support for the family. When the magazine Jet ran photos of the body, Black Americans across the country shuddered, and it helped to jumpstart the civil rights movement. Less than 2 weeks after Emmett's body was buried, Milam and Bryant went on trial in a segregated courthouse in Sumner, Mississippi. On September 21st, the all-white jury deliberated for less than an hour before issuing a verdict of not guilty, explaining that they believed the state had failed to prove the identity of the body. Many people around the country were outraged by this decision. More than 60 years after this incident, the woman who had originally accused Emmett of making gestures towards her in the convenience store had agreed to do an interview. In this interview, she admitted that the accusations were indeed false. The Emmett Till murder and trial brought to light the brutality of Jim Crow segregation in the South. It set in motion a sequence of events that led African Americans in the South to make an unprecedented stand, sparking the civil rights movement. I encourage all of you to learn more, not just about Emmett's story, but the many stories of Black Americans who helped change the course of this nation through perseverance and faith. This has been JC Baker reporting for the WBBN.
I'm gonna push it harder. Gonna climb up higher. It's like I just can't miss. I was made for this. I show the world I'm stronger. Prove it to them I'm a fighter. I can't help but win. I was made for this.
And we're back.
The Brevard South Regional Science and Engineering Fair is coming up on Friday, February the 11th at the Melbourne Square Mall. This event is open to the public. Bayside has 25 students participating in the fair. Come check out what Brevard's brightest are working on this year.
Bayside will be holding a carnival-themed Valentine's Day dance on February 12th. Tickets are now on sale during all lunches in front of the 700 building. The cost is $25 per student.
Attention students, Bayside's student-led Bible study meets every Friday in Coach Johnson's room, 709. It starts at 8 a.m. This is an awesome opportunity to converse with others and learn important principles for living. Coach Johnson cordially invites all students to attend.
On Friday, February 11th, SGA will be displaying a mural at lunch in honor of Black History Month. They will also be passing out information to any student who may be interested in getting involved with student government. Stop by their table at lunch to get more information.
That wraps up this week's edition of the WBBN News.
Make sure you like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Bayside WBBN.
Have a great weekend, Bears.